super team.
But even like teams, I don't know a whole lot about teams, but teams that grow up, that get put together, they depend upon some sense of community.
Yes.
Correct. And when that community falls apart, like, you remember when Shaq and Kobe were beefing?
Yeah.
It was a real problem.
Yeah,
it was a real problem because they were playing on the same team and Shaq was doing raps about Kobe. It was a fucking real problem.
And that kills things because the minute somebody has dominion just on who they are over the group, that becomes a problem because everybody has to share ideas. This structural engineer, you heard me talking about this structural engineer and this architect, he did this amazing study where he took CEOs, lawyers, business students, and kindergartners. And he said, okay, here's the task. 26 pieces of uncooked spaghetti, a yard of tape, a yard of string, and a marshmallow. Might be one last thing, I can't remember. Whoever makes the tallest structure is the one that wins. CEOs, lawyers,
kindergartners. Schools,
the kindergartners.
Kindergartners figured it out.
Because the way they approach the problem. Nobody had invisible ideas of authority. Nobody had sort of, this guy might know more than me. I'm not going to say my thing. They were like, no, yes, there's no, we're all fucking, I'm coming up with my things, idea. And they're like, no, let me do this. And they would just fight over the idea. But it was the best idea.
Who's listening to the kindergartner?
The best idea would win.
I'd be like, shut up, kid, you're five. Like,
shut your ass up.
No, they were all together. It was groups of four. So there are four kindergartners.
Oh, but the kindergartners, the four of them figured it out?
Yeah, they built a 26-inch structure. And the second one was the CEOs. They built a 22-inch structure.
Well, CEOs are thinking about cocaine and pussy.
Probably.
And how their stocks are doing. They're too distracted.
Yeah, they probably didn't give a fuck.
It's a question of, like, what makes children and learn better. You know, I watch kids, obviously, I have them, and I watch them learn things. And it's interesting how some kids learn things really quickly and some things don't, or some kids don't. And how parents just really don't have the ability to learn at the same level the kids do. So I'm like, well, what is it? Is it a physical limitation? Is it a clarity thing? Is it an ego thing? Is it your identity that holds you back? I think it's the amount of time and energy that you put towards something and whether or not you're willing to be obsessed by it.
Yes and no, though, Joe.
And I think that some parents and some people that are adults just do not have the same kind of time that a 9-year-old has to think about things all day. They don't have the same amount of things in their head. They don't have the same – they have too many bills and stresses and distractions and things pulling them away in different angles. And they don't have this sense of who they are the way an adult does. That sense of who you are can be very limiting. You can have this decision that you have in your head.
You put brackets on
yourself. That's what it is.
Yeah, that's a big part of
it. They've done a shitload of study on that. Like, there's a huge body of study on what conditions are the most effective to learn in. I mean, they've done a lot of work on this. And one of the main things that lends itself to learning fast and well is just the idea that you're psychologically safe. The idea that, first of all, there's no shame in making mistakes.
Right.
That's huge.
Can't be afraid to fail. Yeah,
yeah, man. And you will fail.
But there has to be competition too. Like, it has to feel like shit when you do fail. Because if it doesn't feel like shit when you fail, like, there's always the thing that you learn when you win. But you learn more when you lose.
Way more.
You learn a lot more. And I think failing and feeling like shit is important to re-energize, re-motivate, refocus, and then to recognize, this is a bad feeling. I don't like this feeling. I have to work harder.
Yeah, I agree. There has to be repercussions to you failing. Otherwise, you don't learn
much. No, that's true. But you need somebody, if you're a young person, you need somebody to help you navigate out of that space.
Yes,
because if you don't and you feel like shit and then you're shamed, you're told usually you're just not as good.
Right.
And you're not going to be able to get as good. What happens is people quit.
Some people, though. Dude, some people don't, and they dig their heels in, and they get stronger mentally because of that.
Depends on the person. So you need somebody to help you realize, hey, hold on, learning is a bitch.
Yeah.
Learning is a motherfucker. Don't worry. This is part of the process. So let me help you navigate your way out. So the biggest thing that they always do is make you realize that mistakes are necessary, important, and just as good at this stage. They feel like shit. Of course they do. They come with all kinds of weird feelings. Let's stay in this. Stay in this. Learn how to stay uncomfortable in this, and let's figure out a way to get the fuck out of this.
Right, because the real killers and the real winners, they're going to be killers and winners in any sort of scenario, but you can develop more winners if you have a better structure and a better learning environment. You'll have, and then also the community will be better.
Yes.
Like, we keep coming back to that, but I think this is goddamn gigantic. And we're not just talking about community in the sense of people that know each other like on a one-on-one individual basis. What you guys have done with your podcast podcast is create a community. I see the community interacting with itself. I see you guys interacting with your fans. Like, you've made a community of fun, silly people that get together when they come to see your shows.
That's because he and I are silly.
Yeah, for sure. But this is also community. Yeah. This is even people that don't physically know each other.
Yeah.
It becomes a thing, you know? And I think that is one of the least discussed but most important parts of happiness and a part of and most important parts of developing.
Agree.
It's community.
Yeah, man.
It's giant.
Yeah. Yeah, it is. And also, like, learning, like, we had a really good discussion about the podcast, and it was funny how...
I'm going to piss. When I come back,
shit,
we'll talk
first
about
shit, you're taking a piss
what?
Breakout.
I fucked up.
Do you have any eaten today? I feel like I'm going to throw up. I drink so much caffeine. Last time I shit my pants,
we'll talk
together,
about
the UFC
when I get back,
going on.
But learning is important.
Let's talk about Cyborg Holly when you get back.
I like that. That's the first time.
Let's talk about Cyborg Holly when you get back, and Brian, you take a fucking...
Huh?
You take a break.
Oh, I want to talk about Cyborg Holly.
Oh, what were we talking about? What were we talking about?
About how when we have an issue that we want to make the podcast better or whatever.
Oh, when I called you and said you suck on the podcast.
The first thing you do is take care. Like you make sure my feelings are. You take care of my feelings. I do the same thing with you. Like we.
Well, we
want to make sure that like hey, I don't give a fuck.
Well,
we got some
research on the podcast. And I called Brian and said, here's where we get the most listeners. Here's where people turn it off. Here's where we do this.
Yeah,
and I tell Brian this all the time. I go, listen, they might turn off here, but we didn't create this thing to decide what people like and what don't like.
Right.
If you want to do. Fucking an hour of what you want to do, we're doing an hour. We're doing what we want to do.
Yes.
And if they like it, great. But that's how this thing got to where it's at.
Yeah.
So we're going to do whatever you want to do.
Yeah.
That being said, you got to quit doing that.
No, but that being said, you got to be responsible.
No,
to
I
evidence.
Just told him, I said, if you want
to
do it, do
yeah,
it. I'm down, but here's the feedback we're getting.
Yeah, be responsible to
the So let's
do
what
evidence.
You
want to
do, though, but
yeah.
Here's the evidence.
Yeah, and so if you're not going to be responsible
you're fired,
to the evidence.
But here's the evidence.
You're done.
You're
never
done
do it again,
and just keep doing your own thing.
You'll peep when I signal at you. You'll peep when I signal at you. Otherwise,
no. But that's why
yeah.
we've never had that issue
no.
where like oh we got I have to
no.
do this.
Because you
this.
And
I
you and I are
fuck.
About that every single time. No matter even in fights, we'll get a fucking text. Hey man, sorry, a little out of line there.
Yeah, never.
Because
yeah.
all that matters is what works. I don't give a fuck about being right.
No, I don't care.
I want to learn.